has come all the way from Bachahar University, Chasara, as inland external examiner for this study. And I congratulate both the student, Nadia Farooq, and her major advisor, Dr. Asadullah Khan, for producing an excellent PhD dissertation. This is a very good dissertation. The research has been conducted on a very important issue. However, there are always room for improvement. And I have also a few suggestions. These are not questions. I have also a few suggestions to the scholar who is now PhD. And some pertinent questions were also asked by the participants of today's defense. So I would like to suggest a few points to the scholar as well as to the advisor to be incorporated in the final version of this dissertation. Nadia Farooq used a number of concepts and terminologies while she was defending her dissertation, and you may note it down so that in the final version of the thesis, these mistakes should not be repeated again. Number one, if you remember, in the early part of the presentation, I have not seen this dissertation before, but I just noted during the today's presentation. In the introduction, in the very first paragraph, and in the second, and in the third paragraph, you have used old references. Now we are in 2022, so you may use some latest economic survey, maybe 2020, 2021, okay? Because these references were very old, 2017 and so on. Then while explaining some of the tables in bivariate and univariate analysis, you were consistently using the word majority, which was not correct, because when the percentage is 54 or 53, we don't call it majority. So majority means when maybe 80%, 85%, and so on. So in this is, don't write this majority for all the statistics, which is 33%, 54%, and even 60%. So for majority, you may know that majority means majority. Second thing was with regard to conclusions and recommendation, and that point was already pointed out by Dr. Nawfal Khan. We don't write so many over-ambitious conclusions and recommendations, and not in paragraphs. These were big paragraphs. So write them to the point, and not very long in paragraph shapes. Another thing is that throughout your presentation, you were using one concept, and that was agriculture market, and that is not in fact agriculture market, it is agricultural marketing. So you should correct that. And one other thing that I noted during your presentation, and that was aging. Aging in this context is not very appropriate. If you look at the ground reality in our society, in our culture, actually in the agricultural sector and in the farming sector particularly, these are actually majority of our people are not youth who are involved. Actually, these are the mature, senior, and usually old age people who are practically involved in farming. So I don't know in what sense you are using this aging. So aging is not a problem. Another thing is that of the model. I don't blame you people for the model. You have used other logistic models, and I'm very glad that for the first time in the social sciences, especially in the Department of Rural Social Sciences, a PhD scholar has used this model. This is very good model, but let me make a correction. This is not ordered logistic model. Logistic model is in fact a family of models. This is ordered logit model. So make this correction. This should be ordered logit rather than logistic model. One more thing is, I don't know why Nadia Farooq was consistently using these words spurious in her presentation. Spurious is a very negative, you know, word while you are presenting your results. In econometrics, the word spurious regression means regression that is nonsense or nonsensical, and it means it's not logical. So maybe, I don't know in what sense you were using this word spurious when you were discussing the results of the chi square and the gamma. So don't say it's spurious. Spurious means something which is nonsense or which is not logical, which is illogical. In your case, I think in most of the cases, your results were significant based on chi square and even in Arden Lagit model. So if these are spurious, it means that, you know, that's not good. You know, your results are based on your data that has been collected for you by someone and you have supervised or you have advised, you know, the enumerator to collect that data for you. So if these results are based on your data, you should say there is spurious association. Spurious association means something negative, which is not logical.